In this video, I'm going to share with you my 5-step plan based on science and research to help you with your plantar fasciitis. So the 4 most common symptoms with plantar fasciitis are a very sharp and a stabbing pain around your heel or in the arch of your foot. Definitely more pain first thing in the morning, easing off with a bit of movement. So exercises eases the pain, but the pain definitely comes back after resting. And lastly, it's very, very difficult to raise your toes off the floor. So it's not always quite clear what actually causes plantar fasciitis. It could be caused by exercising on hard surfaces. It could also be caused by being overweight. That is definitely a risk factor as well. It could be caused by overpronation of the foot. That means every time you land, when you exercise, for example, you land, your foot elongates and getting a stretch on the plantar fascia. Funnily enough, it can also happen when your foot doesn't have enough mobility, when you have a high arch, we call that. And that's because the plantar fascia doesn't stretch every time your foot comes down. So it needs to absorb too much weight all at once. Wearing flip-flops is a problem, and when you wear shoes with not enough support. Pregnancy is another factor, because during pregnancy, due to hormonal changes, your arches might drop and you might get too much stretch on the plantar fascia. And lastly, it also happens with people who have to be on their feet for a long time, like teachers or factory workers. So the plantar fascia is a connective sheath tissue that runs from your heels to your toes and has 2 main functions. Firstly, it needs to support the arch of your foot, but secondly, it needs to be springy. And the springiness helps with improving the efficiency of walking. So imagine every time your foot comes down, it elongates, and the energy is being released with the elongation of your foot is being stored in the plantar fascia. So imagine your foot being the bow and the plantar fascia being the bow string. So every time your foot comes down, you put tension on the bow string, the energy is being stored in the plantar fascia, and then when your foot leaves the ground, the energy is suddenly released and it makes your walking more efficient. Now, plantar fasciitis is essentially a repetitive strain injury of the plantar fascia. It's an RSI. So the first thing you should do to cure your plantar fasciitis in our 5-step plan is to reduce the inflammation and irritation. And you can use initially ibuprofen or ibuprofen type gels for this to rub on the area. Just be aware, ibuprofens are only effective in the first 6 weeks of the onset of the plantar fasciitis. Because after 6 weeks, the inflammation process changes and ibuprofen is just not as effective anymore. So you still will get side effects, but you won't get the main benefit from taking ibuprofen pills or rubbing on the gel. So the second thing you should be doing is just rest it. I'm talking proper rest. I'm not talking swapping your half marathon for a 10K, but a proper rest. So swap your activities for non-weight bearing activities like cycling or like swimming. That will really help. And only go back to running if you can put a really good amount of pressure on the affected pain area. Also, what you'd be doing is to avoid walking barefoot in the house. Make sure you wear some supportive footwear when you're walking around the house. And the last thing you can do to reduce inflammation is use a bottle of frozen water, what I've got here, and you self-massage your feet. So you put the bottle on the floor, you put your arch on it, and you literally rub and you do self-massage, and you do this for about 30 seconds, a minute, 2 minutes. You can't really do an awful lot of damage, and it reduces the pain, and you massage the tissue at the same time. So you can do this daily. So step number 2 in our 5-step plan is to stretch and self-massage the plantar fascia. And the stretch is really, really simple. All you do is you place the foot in front of you and you pull on your big toe. And you hold this for about 30 seconds to a minute and you repeat 5 times. Now what you can do is you can accentuate this as well by first of all doing a self-massage. And the self-massage, as I said, the plantar fascia runs from your heel to your toes. It runs in a longitudinal way. And with self-massage, is you use your knuckles of your hand and you literally go in the arch of your foot, keep the stretch going and literally massage from heel to foot. Yeah, and the same thing here, you can do this for a good few minutes a day. Doesn't do you any damage or harm if you do this for a bit of a prolonged period of time. This is a very nice way to reduce the tension in your plantar fascia. Now you can also do a little bit more of an intense massage technique. That's called cross friction. Then what you do is you take two fingers and you go crossways over the plantar fascia. So you find your tender point. So say that's here. And all I do now is I go crossways in a massage. This is definitely more intense and more painful, but a very, very good technique to reduce the pain in your plantar fasciitis. So research has also shown that next to stretching your plantar fascia, you should also stretch your calf muscles. It's important to remember that two muscles you need to stretch, the gastrocnemius and the soleus. Let me demonstrate this to you. So the first muscle we're gonna stretch, the gastrocnemius, what we need to do is, I'm gonna show you on my right leg. Place my right foot behind me, push my heel to the floor, make sure my knee is straight at all times, and all I do now with the straight knee is I push my pelvis forward, I feel the stretch in the back of my calves, I hold this for about 10 seconds, repeat about 10 times, and do this 3 times a day. You can do this all day long, to be honest. So that's your first stretch of the gastrocnemius that you need to do. The second stretch is a muscle called the soleus, and what you need to do, again, with the right leg, I place my leg now a little bit in front of me, I'm supporting myself with my left toes. Now what I do is I'm bending my knee, coming forward, keep my heel on the floor, and now I'm stretching the short muscle in my calf called the soleus. So I'm stretching this, holding this now again for 10 seconds. I can feel this a little bit lower. Hold this again for 10 seconds, repeat 10 times, and do 3 sets of these, same thing. So it's important that you stretch both muscles. So step number 3 of our 5-step plan to beat plantar fasciitis is we need to strengthen the muscles in the arch of your foot. And the number one exercise to use for this purpose are heel raises. Now, as you can see, I've placed a towel, a roll up a towel underneath my toes. Reason being, when my toes are pointing upwards, I'm already stretching my plantar fascia a little bit and making this exercise a lot more efficient. So we're going to aim to perform 28 heel raises. Once you can perform 28 heel raises, you're allowed again to go for longer walks or even start jogging. Now the 28 heel raises are 4 sets of 7 heel raises. And what we're going to do is we're going to use the 3-3-3 principle when doing a heel raise. So we're going to come up in 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. We hold it on top for 3 seconds and then we come all the way down. It's important when you come down that your heel drops a little bit below the horizontal. So you should use a book or maybe steps or stairs to do this exercise. So you come up 1, 2, 3. You hold it again for 3 seconds and you come all the way down. So start off with doing 4 repetitions in 3 sets, then see the next day how you're feeling. If that goes well, you move gradually on to 5 repetitions and 3 sets, 6 repetitions, and then ultimately 7 repetitions and 4 sets is what we're aiming for. So 28 repetitions. A brilliant exercise to strengthen the muscles in the arch of your foot and beat plantar fasciitis. So step number 4 of our 5-step plan to beat plantar fasciitis is you need to wear some orthotics in your shoes. And especially if your arch is dropped or when your foot is pronated. Reason being is orthotics will support the arch of your foot and thereby preventing the plantar fascia to overstretch. So you could use some off-the-shelves orthotics. What you could also opt for is some custom-made orthotics. We have a state-of-the-art foot scanner in our office and we prescribe individual orthotics to give our patients the maximum support for their arches. So step number 5 and the final piece of the puzzle to help with plantar fasciitis is shockwave therapy. Now I realize it might sound a little bit off-putting, shockwave therapy, but it's drug-free, non-invasive, non-surgical. And all of this is an acoustic sound wave created by a machine which is directed into the plantar fascia using a handheld device by a therapist. And it's wonderful, it promotes tissue healing, cell regeneration, and helps the plantar fascia again to become normal, healthy tissue. So we offer shockwave therapy in our clinics. There's obviously other clinics out there who offer it as well. So if you combine all those steps and find a clinic in your area that offers shockwave therapy, you're on to a winner. I've really enjoyed sharing my 5-step plan for plantar fasciitis with you. If you enjoyed it, don't hesitate. Give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment in the box below or subscribe to my channel. For now, I'd like to say take care of yourself, take care of someone else as well, please, if you can. And bye for now. Bye-bye.